Diversity is a people issue where we just want people to be comfortable to share their stories. And we're not going to get caught up in you said the right word or not, because that's not the time right now. But we are putting it into place, our definition. So for me, diversity is a noun. It's a fact. It's all the ways that we are similar and different, whether we're talking about people, places, or things. And so the fact that I've lived all over the country, I've experienced what I call geographical diversity. There's a lot of diversity in terms of the climate, the terrain, the weather, we could talk about the food. And so that's a diversity in another way, where we tend to just think about it from a race or gender perspective. And so knowing the dimensions of diversity, whether we're talking about primary in terms of all the ways we were born, in terms of our attributes around race, ethnicity, sexual orientation, abilities, gender. And then as you grow in life and you experience different things is what I call the secondary dimensions of diversity, your interests, where you want to go to school, where you want to practice your faith or worship. Do you want to have kids? And then we have organizational dimensions of diversity where you work, whether it could be a not-for-profit, a Fortune 500, a small-sized company, a startup. Some of us are managers, leaders. And then last but not least are those cultural dimensions, things such as time, the power structures. When we talk about that word diversity, and then inclusion is the action, it's the verb. You know it when you feel included. And so it's acknowledging, it's recognizing, you are utilizing, you're understanding all the ways that someone is similar or different. And then last you're hearing the word belonging, which we're starting to use a lot at MITRE too. So that to me is the emotion, that's the sense. This is how people want to feel or based on the outcomes of that organization. So when they're coming in, they're like, this is how I feel, you know, like I'm included or valued, and it's gonna be different for each of us. So it's an emotional outcome that you want from your organization once you're there. And that will help with the retention. If people feel like I have value, if they're coming to me, they recognize me, they see my skill set, I'm being promoted, I'm being assigned to special projects. It's really our responsibility to better understand our staff, our team, and how they think and what motivates them. So you have to take that time. And the more you do that, that's where that trust comes in, that's where that productivity comes in. And collectively, we're able to produce new ideas, thoughts, products, services. So that is the end game in terms of an inclusive work environment.